injected with a poison.
BANJAX TV.
Word on the street is
crack is selling out, kids. Buy it while it's hot. If you don't get it now, you might never get a chance. Word.
Prepare yourself for the wild world of 1 minute magnifique, where things are not always as they seem.
Now going to be taking a look at a little known underground art movement of the 1920s, namely Pressurism, which was founded by Dr. Gordon, a classically trained painter from Belgium. It was created as a backlash against the direction that Expressionism had taken. He believed that rather than the artist getting his emotion on the canvas, it was about capturing the emotion of his subject upon it. Therefore, Pressurism could be categorized as the art of applying pressure to the subject to gauge a reaction where they are unable to escape the situation, hence providing the opportunity for the artist to paint against the subject's will, resulting in works charged with emotion and oozing with exuberance and energy. We believe it's time to bring this mysterious movement back to the forefront, delve beneath its murky surface and find out exactly
the expressionists that interested me at first, they wanted to deal with emotion within themselves. They wanted to drag out this emotion and put it onto canvas. And that was the essential being of their paintings and ideas. I wanted to move it away from this. I wanted to get it. So it was the emotion of the subject. I could capture raw emotions from my subject. I wanted to put them into a position where they had to give out something. And I wanted to push them into a corner, and so they were forced to emote something of themselves to me. And I did this by putting pressure on these people.
It's not all about the paint and the painting, it's also about the situations I'm searching for. I'm also searching for reactions, and well, a big city, especially when I moved to London, I directly felt that there was really like a lack of contact between the people.
You notice nobody wants to make eye contact with you, nobody wants to have any contact and interaction, and what we were about was forcing them to. Absolutely getting them into a position where they had to react, where they had to interact. And they became involuntary actors within our whole scheme of things.
Yeah, I'm searching for a way to get into their territory where they feel like, I'm trying to open up the people, trying to invade their territory and get into their face. So they have to, in some way, give me an emotions about how they feel. And it's all about invading the personal space of them. So you could say I'm a painter and I use it in a traditional way, but it's also about the performance as well. But sometimes people don't seem to really like it, and it can lead to really awkward situations. I've been, of course people shout sometimes at me, and I've been chased down so many times after run. Sometimes I got beaten up. I had to spend some time in jail, but I didn't really feel bad about it. I mean, my passion for pressurism is so big that I'm willing to go through all that.
When I left Belgium and went to Germany, one of the first people I met was Edvard Munch. And there was the hint of an idea for me when I saw the screen. I saw that face screaming and thought, that person is not enjoying this situation. His emotion that he is giving into this picture is of some sort of agony, of some terrible torment. And it set me thinking that I wanted to get that sort of feeling from my subjects. I didn't want it to be my feelings, I wanted it to be their feelings.
Well, yeah, of course, when I got into pressurism, of course I heard the name Dr. Gordon, the inventor of it all. And I saw this painting of him, of the guards at the Buckingham Palace, I thought it was. So I didn't even went to London to try to do the same as Dr. Gordon, but I saw this picture in one of the city guides books. And I thought, why not? And it was the perfect practice for me as well to try to do this pressurism myself, try to feel what Dr. Gordon must have been felt when he discovered this whole thing. And it was really weird, because they have to keep their straight face. They can't show any emotion at all. But after all, when you stand there with your easel and you're going after him if he does his walk, and you go back and I just went so much into his face and trying to get it. And actually, after all, I got it, and he turned out he had quite a sad face after all. And after that, I was so addicted to pressurism, and that made me open my eyes. It just, was a good choice to go there and do the painting, practice it there, yeah.
Some people said you took it too far. How do you feel about that?
I would say you can never take anything too far. You just go as far as you can. I mean, you've been talking to my wife, I think. She thought I took it too far. She was always berating me that I was hurting the children or messing with their heads and messing with their head. Jesus. It's art. Art. You push, you change, you move, you're never constrained.
My father was eccentric. I mean, he really was. I felt sorry for my mother. She had to put up with an awful lot. She tried to keep us as jolly as she could. But it wasn't easy. It really, really wasn't. And I understand that she had to leave in the end. She couldn't cope with it a moment longer. And then afterwards, my father was sectioned. But sadly, growing up was for us not a happy time. Just wasn't a happy time. It was very difficult. Very, very difficult. Very, very difficult. But as time went on, it just got more and more obscure, the whole thing. And I got really very, very frightened. It was just the memories back at this time. And I know my mother didn't want us to leave us on our own with him. I mean, he was just getting madder and madder. And I really understood in the end why he had to be sectioned. I really do. It was an awful time. And still very, very strong in our minds. The pressure was so great. It was hard. Growing up, I have very, very early memories. Everything was so much pressure, especially mealtimes. He would blindfold us. We would be told we were eating a pudding and then it was something savoury. And it just all got too ridiculous. And as friends, children wouldn't come to the house. They just thought the whole thing was a very, very strange setup. And it really was. I mean, the whole thing was very, very hard. And actually, it really saddens me now, looking back. I don't have happy memories because everything was just so much pressure on all of us.
A situation that was always absolutely brilliant. Meal times. The family meal time. The time when you all sit together and have a nice, relaxing time. But the pressure was on. Take the knives and forks. Change the food around. Blindfold eating, you know, eating with nothing, different types of foods, everything a jumble. It was wonderful. It really got to be where I was at. It was performance art at its best.
Well, basic emotions are not enough for me. I'm trying to provoke as many as I can and try to get the ultimate feeling of emotions, the ultimate anger, the ultimate, I don't know, what kind of emotion pressurism may bring on those people. I really want to get everything out of it, and when I get the best emotion ever, the deepest emotion ever, if I were able to put that on a canvas, then I'm satisfied. But, well, pressurism, to be a pressurist is quite a lonely life. People just tell you to leave. Sometimes it's alright, but sometimes you just get sent out directly and everybody thinks you're funny and a joker, but I take this so seriously. And yeah, I would like the people to respect that a little bit more. Even though it may be funny, but it's definitely not. I'm really trying to get into people's emotions, and I take it really seriously. Remember you told me love was touching souls. Sure, you touch mine, part of you pours out of me from time to time, these lines.